Hello and welcome to a new video on the CrypTool YouTube channel. As you can see, this is a different video than the videos I usually make on this channel. And this is because I'm right now on vacation and I do not make a real video about cryptographic stuff, like for instance a cipher or so. Instead of this, I want to show you another project that I'm also working on, and that is CryptoBooks. And I also want to show you an original cryptographic book that I will show you later. As you can see here right now, I'm on the CryptoBooks webpage, and the CryptoBooks webpage is a webpage dedicated to books about cryptology. Yeah, books about cryptology is another of, or is one of my hobbies, since I collect cryptographic books, historic cryptographic books. And also a good friend of me, Tobias Schrödel, is also a collector of cryptographic books. And he introduced me to his cryptographic books database, I think 1 year ago. And he introduced me several years ago, but 1 year ago, he gave me his original database. And he said that he would like to make out of his database a nice webpage where people can search for these books. In fact, he already did this on his own personal webpage. But the original database was not so nice, the search was a little tedious, and he didn't maintain the database for several years. So we got the idea to create this www.cryptobooks.org webpage that you can see here now on my screen. And we took his original database and we updated the webpage with a nice, more modern looking design, and we updated the database itself to a more modern database, to a more modern database scheme. And as you can see here right now, I'm on the start page of CryptoBooks, and CryptoBooks right now, when you scroll down here, contains about 548 books, all dedicated to cryptography, cryptology. And as you can see here, our oldest book right now is from 1472 that we have in our database. Our newest book right now is from 2018, and we collected about 372 CryptoBooks authors, so people that wrote about cryptographic books. And the idea of this database is to collect all historic books about cryptology. So we don't want to collect new books like books from the 20th century, or when we collect books of the 20th century, we only want to collect books that deal with historic cryptology. Now, as you can see here on the start page, you get some random books from the database. And when you click here on Show Other, you get six different other books from our database. So we have here a book from 2005, that's from the Deutsche Museum. It's Meisterwerke aus dem Deutschen Museum, Band 2. That means Masterpieces from the German Museum, Volume 2. And when you click on these books here, you get more details and some additional information. For instance, we have pictures from inside the book, and here you see why this book was uploaded by Tobias Schrödel to the database. Here you have a nice page about the Enigma machine, I think. And this is an example of an article or of an entry of the database that has not much information right now. So we are still working on that database. So we are also looking for people that help us to fill in information about the books. Tobias and I are both collectors of cryptographic historical books, and I assume that he probably has this book here. And I'm also a collector of historical cryptographic books. I will later show you an original copy of Polygraphiae from Johannes Trithemius. I will also show you the article or the page in the database in a few minutes. And we have, of course, other books or information about books with more text, for instance. I think we could, for instance, let's search for Trithemius. And this is a nice feature in this database. You can enter here, for instance, an author, or you can enter a name of a book. And then it shows you different books or authors, for instance, here. And you can just click, for instance, on Johannes Trithemius, and then you get the information about him. And then we have here all books from Trithemius. And we, for instance, could click on Steganographia here. And this is the first book that Trithemius wrote about cryptology, or as the name suggests, it's more about steganography. And then here you get some nice information about the author, for instance. Then you get some information about the book. And as you can see, many of our books lack of information. So we need people and we need time to add more information on these books. What we try to at minimum add to the database are, for instance, a nice picture of, for instance, the first page or of the book itself, when we have it. Right now, of course, we don't have a copy of Steganographia. This is one book I'm still looking for, so we have no information on, or no picture of a real book here. This here, for instance, now is the information about Johannes Trithemius. He was a German monk. He lived from 1462 to 1516 in Germany. He has some pseudonyms like Johannes Trithheim, Johannes von Trippenheim, Johann Heidenberg, or Johannes Zeller. And here is some information. I think we got this information, for instance, from Wikipedia. Johannes Trithemius, born Johann Heidenberg, was a German Benedictine abbot and a polymath who was active in the German Renaissance as a lexicographer, chronicler, cryptographer, and that's why he's interesting for us, and occultist. He had considerable influence on the development of early modern and modern occultism. His students included Heinrich Cornelius Agrippa and Paracelsus. And Trithemius wrote the first printed book on cryptography, and this is Polygraphiae. And Polygraphiae is a book that I have a copy of. So this here is my copy of Polygraphiae from the 16th century. I will show you details on this book later. And I also uploaded some photos of this book to this database here. And here below you see some book pictures, and right now from Steganographia, we only have a picture of the title page. So if you own any cryptologic books that could be interesting for our database, or that our database lacks of information about, just contact me or Tobias, and then we can upload, for instance, photos if you would like. So let's go back here. And now let's have a look at Polygraphia. And Polygraphia Libri 6. This is the first printed book about cryptology, and the first edition is from 1518. And of course, my book here is not from 1518. My book is from 1571. So it's here you can see, for instance, the editions. 1571 is this here, and we mark this as a fourth edition. And with these old books, it's in fact very difficult to analyze which edition is the first one, the second one, the third one, and so on. So we add these edition numbers by year here. And you see that the fourth edition that I have the copy of here is from Cologne, and it has 554 pages, yes. And of course, what I always do with my books, I try to upload the original pictures. So if you're interested in that particular book or in pictures of that particular book, you can just scroll down here. And when you click on this, you get a nice full screen picture. As you can see here, this is an original picture of my book here. And that's nice that the book is not only here with me, it's also shared to other people like you, that you can have a look at these. And this is the title page of my book with a nice engraving, or with a nice, what's the name in English? It's an author's or the owner's stamp. I don't know the English word for that. And here, this is another book picture. I think I found this in the Bavarian Federal Library. Ah, yeah, here we have the Bayerische Staatsbibliothek. This is a picture of the first edition. And of course, from my book, you have several other pictures. And in fact, Polygraphia is not such an interesting book because it mostly consists of tables for substitution ciphers. And here you have, for instance, an example of such a table. You can substitute, for instance, these letters by words, for instance. But nevertheless, it's a quite interesting book, and it's really a nice artwork, piece of art. And for me, unfortunately, it's written in Latin. Most of the old or very old cryptographic books are written in Latin. You can see also here in the book editions page, you see the language, for instance, Latin. But we have from Polygraphia also a French edition. And of course, where we do not know or where we did not add this to the database, you see no language right now. And this here is also really nice. This is a copper engraving, and I recently found this, I think, on eBay. This is an original copper engraving. I don't know from which book this came from. So what I also do, I collect these copper engravings of cryptographers and of people who wrote cryptographic books. And I also scan these and upload these, so you can also click on this and have a look at this in detail in this database. So I like to share the pictures and data of the books so that they are not only in a bookshelf somewhere and no one can use these. And what else do we have here on the side? As I said, we have here the book editions, we have here the book pictures, and on the top we have a description of the author and the description of the book. So let's go back to the title page of Crypto Books, and now I want to show you how you can search in this database. So not only search via the search function, which is really nice, and what I really like is that this page here, I built this together with Tobias Schröder. We built the database. Then together with a good friend, with Sven Rech, we created this page here. So he helped me creating this interactive page. And then thankfully a student that wanted to make a bachelor project asked us if he can do a bachelor project with us at the University of Siegen. And I showed him this page, and I needed some updates on the page. For instance, we have a possibility to upload via login the books and so on. And this student, I think you can find him here. We have here Tobias, Niels. And this is front-end logic. So Sven Rech is a good friend who helped me to create the page. And then we have Elias Schmittel, who is a student from the University of Siegen, who helped us with the administration part of this page. So let's go back to the main page. So what else do we have here? You can have a look at all the books or at the list of all the books when you click here. And then you get this nice table here, and you can sort this, for instance, by year. So we have the first book in our database from 1472, De Re Militari. And then when you scroll down, it's sorted now by the date. And here we have from 2018, Real Life, Cryptology, Ciphers and Secrets of Early Modern Hungary from Benedict Lang. And Benedict Lang is also a colleague of us who is working with us in the Decrypt project, where we collect, crypt, analyze, break historical encrypted ciphertexts. So probably in the future, I will also make a nice video about the Decrypt project and some of the results in the Decrypt project. So let's go back. Here we have, as I said, the list of all books. And we go back to the start page. Then you have here also the advanced search. So for instance, if you're interested in books from the 16th century, you can use here filters. And then you can say, for instance, 1500 to 1599. And then you can search for occult. And then you get books that contain the term occult, and they come from the 16th century, from 15 to 1599. And here's another book that I also have, or two other books I also have. They are both from Giambattista della Porta. You probably have seen some pictures of these books in some of my videos. I like to use the original pictures because they are really nice. And this, for instance, is the Occultus Literarum Notis. And close this. This is another very famous cryptologist from the 16th century. So he lived from 1535 to 1650. And Giambattista della Porta, you probably also know, because he's an author, and he's famous for this here. This is his encryption disk, or one picture of his encryption disk. And this encryption disk can be used, for instance, for monoalphabetic substitution. So I uploaded from this book, The Occultus Literarum Notis, several pictures, I think, onto the database, onto the webpage. And this is also a very interesting book with nice substitution alphabets and so on. And the original encryption disk that many people probably have seen also in one of my videos is, where do we have this? Is this another edition here? This is a 1591 edition of the Furtives Literarum Notus. And this is the encryption disk. And what I did, I colored these here using Photoshop. And here you have my version of the Furtives Literarum Notus. And here are some nice pictures of the original encryption disks. So these books are really, artworks really beautiful. And if you want to have more pages or want to have, for instance, a PDF or so, I'm happy to share these. This is also one thing that we want to do. We want to scan the complete books. Right now, we only have some examples of pictures in the database, but later on, we want to upload also all pages of these books. But with some books, you can also find these. I think, for instance, with Polygraphiae Libri 6, I think that I have made a link. Yeah, and here you see this. When you go to this link here, you come to the Bavarian State Library, and they have a really nice scan of the complete original Polygraphia first edition. So if you're interested in these books, then you can have a look at these links. So we try to add these links when we find these also to our database. And I said I wanted to show you the original book that I have here. So I will open it right now. So it's bound here with these threads so that it's nicely closed. And I just open this, and then I want to show you, for instance, the title page. Do we have it? The foreword, very long. Can find another interesting thing. It's still the prologue of the book. 40 pages now, 50 pages. Okay. Oh, no, I'm already in the third book, but maybe I can show you another interesting part. As I said, the book itself, it's quite boring, since as you can see, we have here different alphabets inside for encryption. Maybe I can find some more interesting ones with some nice... words. Now you have alphabets, alphabets, and alphabets. Hundreds of pages of alphabets and substitution of words and so on. I have to have a look here. Maybe I can see where is that what I want to show you. This is at the end. And the nice thing is with some of the pages, you don't have even page numbering. So this is the end here. Maybe I can show you this here on the book. And you have to be really careful with these books since they are really fragile. And as you can see, this also has some slight damage on the side. So I tend to not open it so many times and be very careful with it. And the smell is incredible. It smells really old. But as I said, you see not much interesting pictures inside. In fact, this is here we have a copper engraving that I can show you. Maybe you can see it. It's more here. So this is really a fascinating book. And most of the encryption, or nearly the complete encryption parts here in this book, are really weak. So the encryption of Trithemius in this book is really weak. So you have mostly, or all is monoalphabetic substitution, what you have here, as you can see here. And this is not very strong, and not a very strong encryption. I have other books, for instance, from, what's the name? Gaspar Schott. It's also a book I own. It's Schola Steganographia. This is Gaspar Schott. And these are photos of Tobias' version of the book. Here's my Schola Steganographia, which has a really nice title page, as you can see here. And here you have, I think this could be polyalphabetic. I'm not 100% sure. And as I said, these books are mostly in Latin. And the problem with the Latin is that I cannot understand Latin. I started a course some month ago, but due to time issues, I could not finish it. Maybe I will finish the course later when I find some time for this. And this is also an interesting book that I have in my collection. And as you can see, the books where we have the originals, we try to upload all these nice pictures. Yeah, and this is everything that I wanted to show you here with crypto books. So if you have some of these books, or even if you have more modern books, we would like you to contact us and help us. So if you have pictures that you can provide for our database, feel free to upload or to give us these, that we can upload these. And if you're interested in these books, you can use this database to search for the books. So it's really nice bibliography of all, or of, a big part of the cryptographic and cryptologic literature. And yeah, this is everything that I wanted to show you in this short video. I hope that the picture in picture with me works here. So this is not the usual way I will make videos on this channel, so you will not see me in every video, but I thought it's nice to test if this works here. And as I said, I wanted to show you here this webpage, so feel free to surf on this. And yeah, thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next video.